Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. In this video, we're going to try to capture the transit of one of Jupiter's moons across its disk. I'm going to use Celestron Evolution 8 with a 2x Barlow, a dispersion corrector, and an AirSci 224. If you haven't subscribed to Jenham's Astro, then please click the link now and let's see how we get on. So basically, at the moment, Jupiter's coming to opposition and there are lots of opportunities to capture its moons as they make their way across the disk. If you look in the Astronomy Now magazine, and I'm sure you can find the same information online, it conveniently tabulates all the times when the different moons cross the disk. And if I look tonight, it tells me that Europa is supposed to start crossing the disk just after 9 local time and exit the other side just before midnight. So I've got about 2.5 hours when possibly I can capture the image of Europa going across the disk. Now, I've been trying to capture some Jupiter video with the Evolution 8 in the last few months, and I guess my results have been a bit mixed. Had a couple of good images, but quite a lot of the time I haven't got particularly good seeing. So because we're constrained to use this 2-hour period tonight, I guess we'll just have to see, take pot luck to see whether the conditions are favourable. So this is fire capture. As you can see, there is a dot. It is Europa, halfway across the Jovian disk. So there's a clue there. We hoped to capture this from the start of the transit, but the weather didn't play ball. Basically, it was cloudy until around 10:30 we're at now. So never mind, we're halfway through the transit and we're recording a nice black dot of the moon. And we'll have to see what we can make out of it post-processing. So clouds still coming and going, wobbling, typical conditions, but beggars can't be choosers. This is when the transit's taking place. Okay, let's see what we can make of it. So taking the AVI file through AirSci 3, stacked it, then into Registax, played around with the wavelets, and then finally did a little bit of tweaking, sharpening and changing of the brightness and contrast in PaintShop Pro. And I'm pretty happy with the result. Yeah, it's not the clearest image I've ever taken of Jupiter, but as I said before, I've had some sort of trials and tribulations with seeing and certainly not ideal conditions for capturing the planet. So you got a couple of the moons, one on either side. Europa, pretty well right in the middle of the disk, and you just about see the great red spot becoming visible there over on the left. So yeah, hope it's been useful. Definitely worth giving this a go. Easy to find the times of these transits and quite a lot of choices, especially with the planet relatively high in the sky. Maybe pick one early in the morning when it's at its maximum altitude. Okay, thanks for watching.